ओके हेलो एवरीवन, सो टुडे वी विल बी लर्निंग ग्राफ्स इनइक्वालिटी, बट फॉर दैट यू शुड अंडरस्टैंड फर्स्ट व्हाट इज यूनिकली डिकोडेबल कोड्स. सो इफ यू कैन डिकोड द कोड यूनिकली देन इट इज कॉल्ड एज यूनिकली डिकोडेबल कोड्स. इट इज जस्ट बाय द नेम यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड. सो वी हैव टू कोड वर्ड्स, कोड्स, कोड ए. दीज होल थिंग्स आर कोड ए एंड दिस इज कोड बी. So 0 we have 110 110 111. This is code. In code A we have 0 100 110 111. In code B we have 0 0, then 10, okay. In code B we have 0 10 110 001. Okay. Made mistakes. So 0 10 010 001. These are the codes present in B. The code words are 0 10 010 001. And this is code B. This whole thing is code B. And these are code words. Okay. These are code words and these whole things is code A. Now, if you will see this code, so for detecting 0, you can detect it by 0. 1100, you can detect it by 100. 110, you can detect it by 110. And 111, detect by 111. Okay? There is no such combination you can make to detect some other code. Whereas, if you will see code B, 0 can be detected by 0, 10 will be detected by 10, but here if you see 010, this can be detected by 010 as it is or by the combination of these two. You can see first 10 came, this guy, and then 0 came, which makes whole code word as 010, which is same as what we have another one. Okay, so we have this code can be detected by the combination of these two. You can see that. Okay, whereas we don't have this kind of combination here. Each one of them can be decoded uniquely, but here if you see, this can be decoded uniquely, this can be decoded uniquely, but this one is not uniquely decodable. It can be decodable by 010 and it can be decodable by the combination of these two, 0 and 10. Okay, both will give you 010, and at last if you see 001, this is uniquely decodable. 001 means you can't make a combination of other codes. Okay, so because of this reason, this code B will not be uniquely decodable. Okay, not uniquely decodable, and this is uniquely decodable. Okay, so just the idea is each code word should be uniquely decodable in a code, and then you will call it as uniquely decodable codes. If any of the code word is the combination of other code words in a code, then it is not uniquely decodable. You saw the example. Okay, so just have to look for the combinations, whether it can be decodable uniquely or not, and you are done. Means you can call code A uniquely decodable and code B not uniquely decodable. Okay, so this was the idea. Now what graph inequality does is, it is a measure to check whether a code is uniquely decodable or not. If a code follows Kraft's inequality, then it is uniquely decodable, else it is not. Okay, that's why we saw uniquely decodable codes. Now we will see the way to check whether a code is uniquely decodable or not. Okay, now let's look at Kraft inequality. So uniquely decodable code satisfies Kraft inequality, which is summation I is equal to 1 to m 2 to the power minus ni, should be, this term should be less than equal to 1, where ni is the number of bits in a code word and m is number of code words in a code.
Okay,
so let's see an example. This is code A, this is code B. Code words of code A are 00011011. Code words of code B are 01011110. So these are the two code words, these are the two codes and four code words, total four code words are there. So value of m is 4 and ni we have to see here. So for this code, if we will calculate the Kraft inequality, code A, so summation I is equal to 1 to 4 since there are 4 code words, 2 to the power minus n, ni. This can be written at 2 to the power minus 2 because 2 is the value of ni
for first code.
First code, the number of bits are 2. Okay, so 2 to the power minus 2. Then 2 to the power, again it has 2. So minus 2. 2 to the power minus 2, 2 to the power minus 2. So it is 4 into 2 to the power minus 2 means 2 to the power 2 into 2 to the power minus 2 means 1. Because 2 minus 2 is 0, so 2 to the power 0 is 1. Similarly, we can solve it for code B. Summation I is equal to 1 to 4, 2 to the power minus ni. Now here ni is changing. So for first code word, it is 1. The number of bit is 1. So 2 to the power minus 1. Then we have 2 number of bits, 2 to the power minus 2. Then again we have 2 to the power minus 2. Then we have 3, 2 to the power minus 3. Okay, only the ni is changing. 2 is constant. 2 is constant. Only the ni is changing. It depends upon the length, or you can say the number of bits in a code word. Okay, so that's how it will become. So if you solve it, 1 by 2 plus 1 by 4 plus 1 by 4 plus 1 by 8, which will become 4 plus 2 plus 2 plus 1 divided by 8, which is 9 by 8. So if you will see these two values, this is 1, which is satisfying our inequality, or it should be less than 1. But this guy is greater than 1. So we can say this does not follow Kraft inequality. That's why it is not uniquely decodable. Okay, code B. Whereas code A satisfies Kraft inequality. That's why code A is uniquely decodable. Code. Okay, so this is the way you can check. You don't have to track some sort of arrangement here. Just you see, you calculate this inequality. If it is less than or equal to 1, means the code will be uniquely decodable, or else it is not uniquely decodable. Okay, so that's the use of Kraft inequality. I hope you got the feel. Okay.